please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
All steady in the equity space, let's shift our attention to commodities and over to Manisha Gupta for a roundup of all that's happening. Manisha.
Thank you so much for that, Sumaira. Well, it is the China data and the impact on metal prices that we're talking about right now. So on one side, the China non-ferrous metal output for the month of August has been the lowest in last 1 year, and that perhaps could have supported the metal prices. But the other data is about the factory industrial production growth, which also is coming on the weaker side. So that tells you that the demand and the kind of output that they industry output that they have been watching for has been on the weaker side. So the whole host of base metal prices actually are trading in the negative because of this. You have the copper prices trading at a 1 month lows, nickel prices trading at a 3 week lows as well. There has been an increase in LME stocks in last few sessions, and of course the US dollar rebound is something that also seems to be weighing onto this space. The only metal that is trading in the green really has been aluminum. Inventories have seen a decline. The expectation that you will see more cuts, more crackdowns, inspection, etc., has been supportive for aluminum prices. The supply concerns and the strong demand is something that's keeping that space on the higher side. Also, there has been production losses in many smelters and mines, and the expectation that the kind of losses Texas has seen post the couple of hurricanes, the construction, the infrastructure, the building, etc., is something that would lead to more metal demand going forward. So near term, of course, we're looking at some correction, but medium term to long term, markets still are slightly bullish when it comes to this sector. Rupa Mehta of Smriti Commodities is now with us. Rupa, hi. What is your sense for many of these industrial metals as of now?
Hi, Manisha. See, if we talk about the base metal, no doubt base metal is trading red zone in today's session due to weak China data after touches record high. So we would like to suggest position in zinc sell around 193 with the stop loss of 195, and the target would be 190 to 188. Okay. If we talk about another metal like gold, then gold is also in pressure. We are also expecting gold prices can trade downside up to the level of 29,600. So trader can take a short position in gold also.
Rupa, also come in on the crude oil prices, because while yesterday we saw a big gain up, it still is trading at a 5 week highs, but there is some pressure in the Asian and the European markets right now on the crude oil prices. With the various data and events that the crude prices seem to be digesting in right now, at these current levels, are you still a buyer?
Still in these levels we want to buy, because we are expecting some market supply and demands are coming back into the balance. So we are expecting upside momentum can be seen up to the level of $50 to $52. So one can take a long position around, if we talk about the domestic market, then one can take a long position around 3180 in October contract with the stop loss of 3140, and the target would be 3280.
So, Rupa, while you're buying crude, are you also buying natural gas? Because while we did see a huge run-up into prices, up by nearly 10 to 15% during those hurricanes, do you think this is now time to start taking profit, at least in the gasoline prices?